Welcome in to the Business on Purpose podcast. I'm Scott Beebe, your host, the founder and the head coach of the Business on Purpose platform, where we do one thing every day: liberate small business owners from their chaos. Hey, make sure to check us out, mybusinessonpurpose.com/vision. If you need to write down your vision because you're scattered, you have no clarity, you have no direction, we offer it all right there in its complete form. The only thing we ask is that you do it. If you're going to go download it, we ask that you do it. I had two separate coaching sessions this morning with two different small business owners who are both incredibly respected in their industry. They're incredibly respected in their geography. Both had the same challenges. Neither of them are connected. And it's like I had deja vu in the second meeting. It's as if it was Groundhog Day, the second meeting, to the first meeting. It's so interesting, guys. There's so much residual overflow between small business owners. Many of us deal with the same thing. They're different names, different people, different scenarios, but fundamentally the principles underlying both, which is really what we go after. In fact, we value principle more than we do strategy, although we really do like strategy. And in this particular case, one of the things that we teach is something called the 12-week plan. It's taken from the book by Brian Moran called The 12-Week Year. If you've never read it, make sure to go get it. Go to Audible, Amazon, get 12-Week Year, Brian Moran. Moran, I believe, is M-O-R-A-N. I don't get paid to talk about that book, but we use it all the time. In fact, we send it to everybody that's in our group coaching program. We send the book 12-Week Plan along with the book E-Myth and the book Profit First. And in sending that book, The 12-Week Plan, one of the reasons we do that is because we actually teach small business owners to have a 12-week plan. By the way, I said 12-week plan for the book. It's 12-week year is the name of the book. The reason that 12-week plans are so important is because 12-month plans are just, quite frankly, too long. Moran makes the argument that when you create a 12-month plan, you get to January and go, ah, oh, we've still got 11 months. You get to March and you're like, ah, oh, we still got 9 months. You get to June and go, hey, we're good. We're not even to the midpoint of the year yet. We're almost there, but we still have 6 months. Then you get to October and you go, oh my gosh, we've only got 3 months. You get deflated and you don't do anything at all. And so a 12-week plan puts an intense concentration on what it is you're doing, hence the scenario that's going on with these two business owners that I met with this morning. We're about 3 weeks in to both of their 12-week plans at this stage of the game at the time of this recording. And as we're going through their 12-week plan, inevitably both of them, and you can only have up to three goals, wanted to add another goal to the 12-week plan. And in that situation, I could be one of two people. I could either be like a grandmother and go, of course, sweetie, you can have Twinkies, you can have Coca-Cola, you can have whatever you want, whenever you want, because I'm your grandmother and I don't care, right? I care about you. I love you. I want to make you smile. I want to make you happy and I want to make you feel good right now. Now, you're going to have a stomachache tonight, but as long as you're happy right now as a grandmother, that's what I'm happy about, right? That's how grandmothers think. And they're sweet for thinking that way. We don't go to our grandmothers, though, to lose weight. We usually don't go to our grandmothers to gain ridiculous discipline. We go to our grandmothers because they give us sugar. What I would prefer you to be in this situation is like the guy in the Sam's gas station line when I pulled up the other day. I pulled in backwards to the fuel up spot, and I totally missed the arrow that was pointing in. And so I pulled in backwards because there was another car and my cap was on that side of the car. And so it just made sense. I do it all the time, right? The guy walks up to me with his badge and he simply says, I need you to follow the arrows. And that was it. There was no smile, no kindness, no gesture of sincerity. And it's not meant to reflect on Sam's. It's just a reality of the situation. And he said, I'm going to need you to follow the arrows. There wasn't thank you, please, nothing. There was nothing really overtly kind about it. It was just a statement of fact. But you know what I did? I followed the arrows. Now, in that situation, what is it? Was it a big deal that I had come in backwards? No. Could we have gotten away with it? Yes. Is it going to ruin anybody's day? No, it wouldn't have, particularly because the gas station wasn't full. And so it wasn't a huge deal. But what was interesting about it, and I don't recommend his style of customer service, just for what it's worth, but I do recommend his style of being stalwart and following the process. Sam's laid out a process, the arrow pointed the way, I was the guy who missed it, and he called me out. And so in these two coaching sessions this morning, as it relates to the 12-week plan, I want you to be more like the Sam's gas station attendant than I do wanting you to be like a grandmother. Grandmothers will give you whatever you want. Sweetie, if you want a fourth goal, take a fourth goal. Because it's not that they're necessarily concerned about the long-range aspects. Now, of course they are, right? But really what they're looking for is they want you to be happy right now. That's what grandmothers do. But what the gas station attendant who's following the process at a Sam's wants you to do is he wants you to follow the rules. He wants you to follow out what the process is laid out to be. And as a coach, knowing that it is in the best interest long-term of the business owner to follow the 12-week plan, to be fanatical about it over a period of 12 weeks, because at the end of the day, it's just 12 weeks. And we can add this new idea to the next 12 weeks, which is why we have a future holding area on the 12-week plan. And any future things that go, we put them in that area so that we can come back to in the next 12-week plan. But for now, I'm going to be like that gas station attendant at Sam's who says, follow the arrow. Next time, follow the arrow. And so with these clients, we were able to encourage them, bring them back, and they always admit, go, I know, but God, that new idea sounds so good, and they get it all the time. I want to encourage you to make your own 12-week plan. It's simply three goals over the next 12 weeks that you're going to be laser focused on. And each one of those three goals is going to have three, four, five, or six tactics. And a collection of tactics will give you success to the goal. So the idea is if you have done the tactics, then the goal will be complete. So my question for you is over the next 12 weeks, what are the three things that you need to stay laser focused on? Now, Gary Keller would say, what's the one thing? So you can summarize it in one thing, but ultimately take three goals and then lay out three to six tactics for each goal. And then when you get that little lull in the day, you know where you go scroll Facebook because somebody's late 3 minutes to your lunch or whatever it might be? Instead of scrolling Facebook or scrolling something that's not going to matter in 5 years or 8 years or 15 years, why don't you pull out your 12-week plan? Stay laser focused. Be like the Sam's gas station attendant. Follow the arrow. And your 12-week plan is the arrow. Hey, periodically, go to grandma's house. Get your Dr. Pepper. Get your hostess cake. Get your donut, right? But just do it periodically. But every day, I want you to build a habit to follow the 12-week plan. And I want you to be more like the Sam's gas station attendant than I do want you to be like grandma. Hey, I hope this has been helpful. If you need more help beyond, go to mybusinessonpurpose.com. Again, if you're feeling scattered, delirious as a small business owner, go to mybusinessonpurpose.com/vision. 100% of our vision tutorial and template are there. The only thing we ask is that you implement it. If you download it, we ask that you implement it. If you're not going to do it, then we ask you not to download it. It's our delight to be able to serve you. And join us next time, right here on the Business on Purpose podcast.